Good morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are. You are welcome once again to a video where from this lesson we are getting closer to the end of the whole of this end. In the previous videos, we talked about the arrival of the Europeans and their time they came, and then we end up by talking about the European missionary activities, the churches established by the European. As I said it in those videos, we said there are a lot of churches nowadays, but we want to pick out those that in Ghana presently that were established by the white men, not our own Ghanaians. So today we are coming to look at the impact or the effect, positive effect of those churches. The effect that the establishment of the churches or Christianity has on the people of Ghana. We first have what we call introduction of what? New crops. We learn somewhere far from this topic that some crops we have in this country, they were brought up by what? The European, especially the missionaries. So a good things he did to the people of this country is the introduction of Western medicine. We use traditional medicine, popularly known as the Adibidro, but the time the white men came in, they established a hospital and then they brought in their own doctors to train our people. From there we started having access to what? Good healthcare facilities, and then our system has completely changed. We also have abolition of inhuman practices. Inhuman practices are practices that are not morally good, such as human sacrifices and then the troposy system. In those days in Ghana, these sacrifices were rampant, but it took the establishment or the churches, the missionaries, to convince the people using the Bible and telling them the good moral values that God requires from us. We also have a skill training. Skill training simply means the people train the locals in what? Shoemaking. We have carpenters, they train the carpenters, the goldsmiths, so on and so forth. So those people we have today, it took what? The Europeans what? To train our people to what? To acquire the knowledge of carpentry and tailoring. We also have establishment of schools. In class basics 5, when you go to basic 5, we'll look at the schools that were established by the what? The missionaries, the churches. We have the Basel missionary churches that established a lot of schools. We have Wesleyan churches, so on and so forth. We also have introduction of coins. We learned that the first exchange, a system of exchange used by our forefathers, was known as barter trade, good to good. But when the white men came, since they were using the coins, money, currency in their own country, they came here and introduced them, and it put an end to the barter trade system. And we also have translation of the Holy Bible into local dialect. You know, we talk about schools, the churches trained the adepts or the new converts to what? To read and write their language. So what the next thing that happened is that they trained many of them in reading Bible and writing in the local language. So we have, for example, a white man called Reverend Schlegel from Germany, who translated the Heavenly Bible in 1858. They translate the Holy Bible into what? Every language. We also have the three. Then we have three major local languages in which the Bible was translated. We also have what? Reverend Johann Gottlieb Kreisler, also from Germany. He also translated the Holy Bible into three languages in 1871. And finally, the major language was Gan. The Gan language was also translated in by what? Another German called Johann Zimmermann, or you see Zimmermann, but normally the correct pronunciation is Zimmermann. He too was in charge of the translation of the Holy Bible into Gan language. That was done in 1886. So these are some of the significant changes that the white men brought into our Ghanaian society, especially when we are talking about the introduction of Christianity. We thank you so much. In another edition, we'll be talking about some few negative changes that the Christianity brought to Ghana. Thank you and meet you there. Bye.